Mark and BC on the Adam Bomb Show. You can see BC a mile away. No, her hat, Mark.
Her hat. It's I don't lose her in a crowd.
It's like one of those construction workers that have the big. So now, you know, you two have been at this a while.
Yep.
As obviously a couple, but as a musicians traveling. Yeah. What have you learned about each other as musicians? Because is it tough to separate the personal life from the professional life, or does it not even matter at this point?
I think our life is music, and our career is our life. So I think it's always kind of going to be intertwined. You can't really escape that, especially with social media and the way everyone lives their lives. I mean, everything is out there. That is business. That is part of. So Mark is very 24 hours a day, ready to work all the time. I'm the mood ring. I need to be in the mood.
How do you get Mark to slow down? That's what I want to know.
I usually throw some sort of fit, or I start to ignore him. Or I'll ignore him. He's like, why aren't you listening to me? I'm like, I'm listening to you. I'm just sick of hearing
the
same.
She hits the mute button.
He's DJ Repeat. I call him DJ Repeat. DJ
Repeat.
Yeah.
I think she's so funny.
That's amazing.
No, but it's good. We balance each other out.
Most people would say, like, on paper, I'm like, oh, I could never do that with my, you know, significant other.
Right.
But for us, it works. You know, we actually tend to bicker or, like, argue more when we're apart. And for this, it works because... And the main thing is we both respect each other greatly, and we bring different things to the table. And, you know, if we have a disagreement in creating a song or something, usually if one's feeling really adamant, we usually respect that and, you know, trust each other.
Alexander Jean on the Adam Bomb Show. That's Mark and BC. And let's talk about Waiting For You. Give me the vibe of that single.
Waiting For You is a very fun, up-tempo, more up-tempo than what we've normally done or put out in the past for singles. But the lyric is... doesn't mean that the lyric's not as intense and raw and honest as our other stuff. This actually really digs in deep to past relationships, the crap we've been through, leading up into meeting, and really giving purpose to the crap we've been through. And
No,
I was just going through all that while I was waiting for you, my person.
We always said when we first started dating, like, it's a wonder we never met before because we had so many mutual friends. We used to go to the same places. And, like, I wonder how many times she was at the bar while I was, like, getting money at the ATM. Or I gave someone, like, I shook someone's hand at a table that she was sitting at. Like, I wonder how many times that
clearly wasn't wearing
happened.
The hat.
I can tell you, Mark's been working constantly, so he didn't pay any attention. He was too busy working. But
We had these parallel lives. And, you know, like BC said, if you read this song as a diary entry, you'd be like, damn, it's, like, heavy. But the music, the instrumentation, and the feel of the track, it kind of gets, you know, you want to move to it. It's up-tempo, but it's very real, raw, and it's honest.
And the video is a lot of fun.
Yeah. Is it fun making videos? I've never made one.
We love it.
Can be very stressful, though.
You're right. We are
it's the time. You're always like, shit.
Well, we're independent, you know, so we're paying for it ourselves. We got a certain amount of hours to fit in this video and get it done, and we got the crew, and everyone's working on a budget for us and trying to. It's a passion project for everybody, you know, and that's what makes it so cool. Yet also can be really difficult and stressful.
You know, that's so important to know that you're independent right now.
Yeah. Yes.
So does it change? I don't know. It changes everything though, because everything you have is going into this, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. I think it's the things that most people don't see. It's like when we have a gig. We bring all our own gear.
Our
we
own
set
crew.
Up all our own gear. We tear down our own gear. We close out at the end of the night. We write and record and do
We're
everything ourselves. We have a great team of people who have, you know, become like family that believe in us and who are, you know, with us to help us get to the next level. But, you know, it's very much, we do this because we love it. It's not a vanity thing. It's not like, we do this because we love doing it together as well. And being honest, being raw and real. And this year I think it's going to be a good year. We've got some good ones loaded up in the canon.
Good.
And hopefully be releasing one every 6 to 8 weeks this year. So, yeah.
I've heard a lot of artists say that, they're releasing every month or every, you know, so often. Is that the new thing? I don't know.
It's attention span.
Yeah, like, everyone has ADD, right?
Like, everyone, yeah. It's hard to, like, I mean, people like myself, you, mm-hmm. I think we love albums. But in this generation, it's kind of like people are so on to the next so quickly. So why release?
Keeps going.
Yeah, why release 12 songs and two are going to get looked at? So you want to keep it fresh, you know? Build an album over a year.
You're going to go on tour this summer.
Yeah,
what's the one place that you two can agree on that you loved playing so far? Is there a place or a city?
Well, our most recent show had an elevation to it in New York.
In New York, yeah.
And I don't know what it was. It was an intimate crowd, but it just, we sold out And then they asked us to come back the next week, and we sold out, and they put us in the bigger room. And that's everyone awesome. Was just singing along, and there was something, I don't know, every show is really special. It's been a lot of fun. I mean, we love after the shows, especially getting to meet everyone. It's hard to do it, but New York City always has our back.
Yeah.
Something special over there.
New York is great.
Yeah.
Are you noticing the building of fans for you two?
Absolutely, yeah.
Just for the music, yeah?
Absolutely. Yeah, I can feel it.
Because at the end of the day, that's what it's about for us. I mean, of course, you know, there's other elements to life and, oh, you're married and you do all these things. But, like, at the end of the day, the root of it, the source of it is because we both love music. We love creating music. And it's cool to, like, watch the Spotify count tick and grow up and, like, take steps. It's amazing to watch. And people who are coming onto our page be like, hey, new fan here, just saw this from this. Like, hey, new fan here, blah, blah,
that's
blah.
Cool.
Well,
that's
cool. I was
awesome.
Going through that. So. That song got me through this. And, you know,
yeah.
Thank you for putting it out.
That's cool, though, to get
therapy.
That, right? I mean, yeah. Not a lot of people can experience that.
Yeah.
For sure.
All right, so Waiting For You is a single and on tour this summer, right? Do you have it?
Looking to right now.
Looking to.
Figuring
it
out.
Yeah. It, yeah.
Well, we hope they do, right? Yeah. All right, Alexander Jean, thanks for coming by, guys,
on
the Adam Bomb Show.
Thank you.